Welcome to International Securities Exchange's podcast series. Facilitated by renowned educators, ISE podcasts are intended to teach beginning as well as seasoned investors the ins and outs of trading. To find an updated list of podcasts, please visit www.ise.com/podcasts. Please be sure to listen to our important message following this episode regarding the risks of investing in exchange-traded options.
So, next, USD versus Canadian dollar, CDD, the IIC taker. Okay. So last time, Cyril told you to be very cautious on the Canadian dollar, because it was approaching a very interesting support, but it was very very risky to enter a position at this stage because we were close to break below this support. But he told you I'm still long. It's worth staying long in this kind of configuration, as the RSI was turning up at the time. So, and he was right again, because this strong support hold very well on the downside, and the pair rose very sharply, and which I think even our second objective. So this is a great success for those who follow Cyril advice 3 weeks ago. But we'll be cautious on this pair right now because there is a declining trend line, which is not really well drawn with this with paint, but my technical analysis software, it is I apologize again for this problem, but we are approaching a declining trend line, and the pair could pull back, or even reverse down, because this is a very strong trend line, which is in place since August from the last year, so nearly 6 months. So if you think the pair will break above this resistance, in my opinion, you should wait for a pullback to pay your option cheaper, as I said before, because volatility will be lower if a pullback takes place before. And yes, this level around 105 seems to be interesting level. This is an intermediary support, but an interesting level to enter a long position, and if you're playing a break above this resistance. A break above this resistance will lead to a further upside toward 112 and .50 to be precise, and then this resistance, huge resistance, and at this stage at 117.50, I think the upside potential will be very limited if you reach this level. So at this stage, short position will be nice, but we are not still there. So my advice for the moment is to wait for a pullback, try to buy this level 105. Or if we if the pair broke above this level, try to wait for a pullback, a slight pullback to enter a long position. Always the same dilemma. What we have then? The New Zealand dollar, the Kiwi, as we say in the FX world. So the Kiwi is has the same pattern as the Swain, the Aussie, the Aussie doll, the Australian dollar. This is a kind of rounding bottom, but not very well identified. But the technical indicators are well directed. And the pair is breaking above very interesting resistance. And in my opinion, this is a very good buy signal. And the next target is set around this level, 152.50. And this is the the main target of this kind of falling bottom. And you'll see the yeah, this is a nice target in my opinion. You can retrace the objective, as I told you in a slide before. This may be a nice one. Nothing less to add on this pair, as it exotic pairs are only very well correlating one another. And the last one was Fona, the last. We don't have as the other pairs, this is a buy, this is a bullish bullish pair because the US dollar is bullish. The RSI is still well directed with a bullish trend line. You can see more precisely the rounding bottom, more precisely than with the New Zealand dollar. And this is also a very nice bullish pattern. So next target is set at 80. And as for the other pairs, wait for a slight pullback. Counter long position.
Thank you for listening to our podcast. To find more podcasts on options, stocks, alternative markets, and market data, please visit www.ise.com/podcasts.